Well, hello, welcome to Drawing with Fire. I'm Valarie, your neighborhood pyrography artist, here to help guide you on your burning adventure. And I'm joined with Hubcap.
The Muffin Man.
Now you're the Muffin Man, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
I am the Muffin Man.
He has decided that every time we're going to have a new name, huh?
What?
Yeah.
No.
What was last week?
Haven't you heard? I am the Muffin Man.
Hi, Grace. Hi, Sam. Hi, Eve. Hi, Chris. All right. So I worked more last night on the waterfall. It still needs to be darker, but I at least have some of it in. At the end of this, I'm going to do a video with all the water instead of doing separate ones in order to... So there's a little more educational. That's the word I wanted. Yeah. So today I am going to work on this close-up moss. Now in the original photo that is right here, if you notice, it's a straight line, but when I was making my pattern, I actually curved it because I wanted to have more movement to it. So that's why it's not exact. Hi, Loretta. Welcome. And this is our photo, hopefully. I guess it'd help if I did the right. There we go. So that is the full, both sides, everything that I'm working on, if you haven't seen it before. So today, this area right here is where you see the little mushroom. Back off here. That's kind of bending down. That's the area I'm going to be working on. And for my reference photo, I actually went in and tried to put some light in the areas that I thought would be coming down. So because we have the giant mushroom here, it's going to be blocking all this. And this area is going to be even darker. But I just needed a kind of a visual reference so that when I go back and darken even more area, I'm not taking out all of my lights, because I need those lights. So I'm going to pop this up on my board somewhere. And I think because of the texture that's in here, I am going to start with the sphere shader. So I need to switch that out. So how is everybody doing?
They're all saying hi.
Hi. Where'd my spear shader go? There it is. So
Sheila Edwards is here.
Hi, Sheila.
And Cheryl Bennett.
Hello, Cheryl. All right. So is this bright enough on the screen? I have some lights off so that my eyes don't get so tired. I just want to make sure. And this is not the screen I want. I need to move it down. And that goes that way. That's still not enough. So I'm going to have to hold it up. So this is the area. I think I'm going to probably actually start over here by the queen. If you notice on my pattern, we don't have the full side of this coming down here. Some of it wraps around to the side on the pattern that I haven't transferred yet. So I think I'm going to start in the darker areas down here and build those up. And what a lot of these lines are is to show me where the shadows are within the moss. Because this is definitely going to be a lot more detailed because it's closer to you. There's more moss in the background, but that isn't going to be as detailed. So under here, I actually removed one of the mushrooms. Don't know why I left it in this photo. So I'm actually not going to get too bogged down on the strokes I'm doing, because the squigglies will help us. So I'm gonna get some of those in. In fact, I can go darker. I will say I'm liking burning on the treacle board. I do like it. So did everybody watch the announcement video yesterday? I am excited. If you haven't seen what I announced yesterday, I've got an iCard and the video's in there. So, do I need to zoom in a little bit?
Maybe a little bit.
Hopefully. We won't lose focus. I got to click it on for a second, let it refocus.
Looks clear to me.
There we go. Is that a little better? All right. So we have stems that are hanging over, and I'm just kind of negative burning the darks around it. I'm not getting too bogged down in trying to get every stem in.
Oh.
Hmm?
Chris says, looks amazing, but also, yes, awesome news, World Pyro Month, cannot wait.
Yay.
And Cheryl says, yes, I'm looking forward to August.
That is so cool. I can't wait. This has been bouncing around in my head for, how long now? A good, almost a year. I think I started having the idea about a year ago, but I couldn't figure out how to do the technical part, because burning wise it's not as easy to be to just pull something out and start burning it without planning. So I had to figure out how to kind of plan it.
Mm-hmm.
It's less spontaneous. That's what I'm looking for. And with Inktober and World Watercolor Month, which is started on Sunday, those are a lot easier to get spontaneous with.
Mm.
So I'm just kind of bouncing around. Some areas can be darker, some can be lighter. Even in the dark areas, nothing's going to be a flat burn.
What is your burner set up right now?
I'm at 3.5.
Okay. Cyan Ink Art says, yes, I am happy that there is now a month for Pyrography.
Yay! And I'm hoping that it'll be good practice for everybody, including me. It kind of takes you out of your comfort zone, because you're not burning the same things over and over again that you're comfortable with, which helps you to learn more. If you don't want to share it with anybody, you don't have to. And by keeping them smaller burnings, they're easier to do in a shorter amount of time. I do need to order a treacle board for that. I don't have an 11x14.
Mm.
The one I showed in the video is a 9x12 block board. But I did notice the treacle boards do burn easier. Or I'm sorry, they burn well. They sand easier. So our light's coming down here. So this is going to be different values of darks.
Oh no.
What's wrong?
Grace's chat isn't working.
Oh no.
Got a message from Eve. So Eve says, Grace says bye.
Oh, bye Grace. I'm sorry your chat's not working.
What are we going to do without Grace?
I don't know.
Smart.
She's your buddy.
What?
What are you going to do?
It's not me that's upset. What about Bernadette?
Oh boy. No temper tantrums, please. Alright. So just trying to get them in. I'm actually not paying too much attention to the lines.
Me neither.
As they're laid out. And this is more in the middle of the reference photo because we have the two smaller mushrooms here. And the big mushroom was behind. In fact, there's the big mushroom. The big mushroom is back here. So that kind of gives you an idea of where we're at. So I'm just tapping them in and squiggling around.
Looks good. Yep, I call that a day.
I gotta get a little bit more in. But I can kind of negative burn some of the shapes in. And the moss in the background that's further up is going to be a lot more out of focus.
How are you going to make it?
I don't understand that. And I checked the settings. And even today when it started, it said we were good. Oh, I need to stop burning.
Okay, it looks like...
Are we back?
Yeah.
All right. So just tapping and wiggling. Some areas are going to be darker than other areas. And even that, I'm not too worried about because I can go back and do an overall shading of the burn for where I want things darker. So right now, and down here, that is part of the branch. And if I turn... Ooh, I don't have to hold it as much either. Okay. But I am going to have to shift. There we go. I need to be able to reach it. So underneath, I was thinking about how to do this because under here we have the foggy water. And if this is going to be considered more similar to a peninsula that's coming out for her perch, there would be light hitting behind, and in doing that there would be a little bit of cast light underneath to give a more round feeling. So
if there was a peninsula that was made out of pins, would it be a peninsula or would it be a peninsula?
Peninsula. We'll go with that. So I'm just gonna, you and your dad jokes. You give me a hard time about mine.
I'm so tired.
I know you're so tired.
I'm not even yawning tired. I'm past that. I'm a fall off the chair and...
So if we hear a thump, that's you on the ground?
Thump and then snoring. It's me. Because I will not wake up.
Wow.
I don't know why I'm so tired.
It is tired. So this needs to be darker. And actually for the tree bark, I think I could switch over to the ball tip, which I've already got on. And that way I can get a little bit more texture in the ball tip. I did get some moss in there.
Cheryl, I'm drinking coffee right now.
He's trying. I'm just waiting for the tip to heat up. Alright. Because it's only 3.5, the ball tip does take a little longer. There's more to heat up at the bottom. So let's get some of this bark in here. In fact, it's not going to be like really bright, even with the light. So I'm just going to go along with the direction of what the bark would be. Hopefully I stay on camera. Let's get that filled in. And then I can erase some of my lines. And the bark moves in the direction. What?
You told me to bark.
I did not tell you to bark. Bark.
Yes, I heard it clearly. You said bark, and then I said,
We have entered the not sure if he's lost his mind stage.
I think, you know what?
Your delirium stage.
I know what this is. I know what this is.
What is this?
Well, okay, you told me that I'm more entertaining when I'm sleepy. And we're broadcasting today. And so you must have put something in my coffee earlier.
No.
Like horse tranquilizers or something.
No, I would never do that.
Or maybe it was like you snuck up when you're in the hall while I was sitting on the couch and you had a blowgun with curare darts. And you're like,
yeah, because I have like, so many of those lying around the house.
And I was like, oh, mosquito. But now I'm so sleepy.
Yeah, because we have so many of those. So many. All right, let's take some of this pencil line off. I'm not going to stress if I take any pencil line out of here off. Now I can darken up the areas that are under the moss, because those are going to be darker. I probably could bump up to 4 with the ball tip.
Pix by Liz is here.
Hi, Pix.
And I don't
Liz.
Podge is here, too.
Hey, Podge. Here just in time for Jason to hit the floor.
Hit the dance floor.
Actually, I think you are tired enough. You would dance.
Hmm?
You don't normally dance. But you're at that.
Back in the 80s, I was an amazing dancer.
In your own mind, yes, you were.
Everybody knew that when I hit the dance floor and that when I put on my fingerless gloves, that it was serious. Pop my collar on my members only jacket. Look out. No one does the robot like me.
Oh boy. You hear the other guys in the barracks load when you did that.
What? No! I wouldn't dance in the barracks. That'd be weird. Talk about in Germany. At the club. At the disco.
How often did you go to the club?
I actually went to the club multiple times.
Did you?
Yes, I did.
That is a surprise.
Yeah.
Let's see here.
Germany wasn't ready for me dancing, so a lot of times, like me and like Billy Idol, I was dancing by myself.
Oh, so you have a new song to stick in their head today.
Well, Chris, it depends. Like 2 fingerless gloves, if if I was like dancing hard, because you know that makes a statement.
It's hard to burn and laugh. Look at that. You got Cheryl tired. She needs to go get her coffee. All right. So I'm just trying to get up underneath where the moss would be casting more of a shadow. And see, I know that the ball tip is not burning smooth, but I'm using that to my advantage.
And I know what you did last summer.
I started going live.
Yes, mainly Pyrography stuff, yes.
Yep, we have now, it was as of...
Oh yeah, we didn't address that last
time. We didn't,
time.
I forgot.
We better address that.
Well, as of June 18th, we had been going live for a year.
That's right.
Alright.
So let's get our illustration open. Is at lunch, at work, just want to jump on and say... Hey,
Thew.
That is a very dapper top hat, Thew. I don't know if that's Thew in a top hat or if that's something else, but I'm going to just assume that that's Thew in a top hat.
All right.
If you can pull off a top hat in today's society, that's something.
It is.
Yeah.
I suppose you don't have one.
No, I couldn't do that. Like, you gotta know your wheelhouse. Like, if it comes to, like, fingerless gloves and members only jackets and headbands, I can rock that. But If I tried to do the top hat, people would just be like, what are you doing? It's not you.
It's not you?
Nope.
What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to look at my pattern, since it is different than my reference photo on layout. Alright, so there we go. I didn't transfer all the lines, so I just wanted to make sure that we're only getting a little bit off the edge, and I'm too zoomed in. There we go. There we go. So this is the branch I'm working on right here. Roll that up and keep it out of my way.
That is such a detailed pattern.
It is. But yeah, I didn't even transfer all the lines because that's why I was looking. Right. I've got moss hanging down here. But now that I looked, I know that the curve, the edge is right here versus right here. And that's what I needed to see. So this is moss and tree hanging down.
Leather top hat. Wow, that's much respect.
Are you jealous?
Yeah.
Should I get you one?
No.
Not that they can see you, but...
No.
You sure?
No, I always wanted leather pants, though. Can you imagine the leather pants and the fingerless gloves?
Well, I can burn all leather.
That would take my dancing up to that whole nother level.
And when are you hitting the club?
Well, I don't anymore.
While I'm asleep?
I don't anymore.
Yeah, let's get some darks in here. Again, I'm not being... very absolute about this. I can switch back over. Get it off my brush. Hopefully.
Chris says, wow, happy live anniversary. And Theo says, big hugs, thumbs up.
Well, thank y'all. And next week, or this week is tomorrow. Tomorrow. Goodness, it's 4th of July already.
Tomorrow.
And next Wednesday is my birthday.
Tomorrow's a day away.
Yes, it is. Yeah, and next week's my birthday, and next week is also the 2-year anniversary of the channel.
So you're like...
Yeah.
28, 29?
No, I earned every bit of that gray in my hair.
You don't have gray in your hair.
It actually looks kind of cool in the video. It's like I colored a streak, but I didn't color a streak. That is all earned.
I have gray hair too.
Because you're old.
Shut up! I love you.
I love you. So I switch back over to the spear shader. And I'm just gliding it over. Just trying to get some of the form. Because in this area, I guess I could go up.
Eve says, ouch. Well.
Ouch. What did ouch. I ouch?
What?
Uh-oh, my hair's falling out. I don't know. I don't know. She's going to have to tell you.
I'm tired. I'm sure I missed this.
Probably because I said you're old.
Oh. Oh. Yeah.
Well, you're older than me.
What? Chat's sticking up for me? Oh, Grace isn't here.
Oops.
Ah, Grace. I miss having Grace in chat.
I'm also using the edge of the tip so I can get a thinner line and then kind of bring it out.
Yes, the mean thing you told Jason. I'm not old. I'm middle-aged. Because she's oppressing the people.
But you're my old. So. Now I'll be 4.5.
4.5.
Yeah.
Wow. Sorry, Corinne told me I was old yesterday.
Did you?
Yeah, because I had to fill out that form.
Yeah.
And put my age. And she's like, year old dead.
It's only because she's 17.
Yeah, I know.
She'll get there one day.
Yep. Oh, that was a sobering thought.
I know. Every time I get older, it makes my parents older. Yeah. The gift that keeps on giving. So, just bouncing it around. Again, I know this area is in shadow. So I'm not... And things are crossing over each other. We can start kind of putting in some more lines. Define it a little bit more.
Wow, you were like burning fast.
Because this I can just skip around. I'm not... not everything's going in. Because if I tried to put every single leaf of the moss in, it would be so busy that it would really take away from the piece.
Yeah, that's true.
So I'm just trying to... And see, I can push some back by just shading it very quickly.
Oh, Eve has to go for a short break.
Oh,
She'll be back.
Okay. That means you can't fall asleep at the wheel.
I'm the only mod.
You are.
Oh, no.
Hey, I'm not
popular. I've never actually had to do my job.
I'm not popular enough for a troll to come in.
Aww.
They pop in and look and go, oh, no. It's just, no. Not worth the time. I'll be a real YouTuber when a troll comes in. So, I'm just turning it aside and get some of the smaller areas to darken up.
So, I know this is probably a combination of me being tired, but then mm-hmm. I had a thought. So, So Bob Ross, you know, he was never, if he had been around during the YouTube age, and done his paintings.
Yeah.
Do you think that he would have had trolls?
Yeah. He would have.
I don't know. Bob's...
Well, there's people in the art world that didn't like him.
So, like, snobby curators and clinics going on anonymously and trolling Bob?
No.
Your hair sucks. I can't take you seriously.
Yeah, I'm sure there would have been.
It feels terrible just to say it. Sorry, Bob.
I think there would be some.
Oh, Steve has to go. I guess, yeah.
Bye, Thu. Yeah, he's just at work. So. Thanks for sharing your break with us. So, gotta put some of those back in. In fact, most of these are going to have to be pushed in because they're not, with the way the light's hitting, they aren't going to be standing out. But I do need to get rid of some of that pencil line. I've already gotten rid of most of them. I don't want to be showing through the burning. My hair's falling. There we go. And I haven't been testing the tip, the heat setting too much because I'm really not worried about that.
Okay.
This area actually lets me be a little more relaxed.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's good.
Even though I'm trying to get more detail in, because moss looks differently all over the place, it really... really doesn't matter if you get every single line. In fact, I could have gotten away with not really transferring anything. Probably would have saved me some time.
I lived in my childhood in Wrangell, Alaska.
Mm-hmm.
It's a rainforest. There's so much moss there.
Yeah.
Everything has moss. Like, you could fall down in the forest.
Take a nap.
And not, well, yeah, you could take a nap. I'm just saying, if you tripped, you probably wouldn't hurt yourself. Because you'd just be like, phew.
Phew.
I actually have laid down in the forest.
So now I'm just going to try to stick to this area so that I can get it closer on being done. I don't know that I'm going to have time to work on this for next week because I need to start and finish the July Animal Artist Collective piece. And I have not started burning that yet. Oh no.
Oh dear.
Luckily it's a 7x11 with not...
7x11?
Oh that, yeah!
Is that a coincidence?
It is. It is. And the video goes up on 7/12.
On 7/12. So it's just... So the dimensions of your birthday that goes up the day after your birthday.
Yep.
Wow.
And on the date of my 2-year anniversary on YouTube.
Wow. Let me make sure there's no planets aligning during that time.
I don't know. Maybe we should buy a lottery ticket.
Either that or else fallout shelter or something.
No. Let's see here.
Sam Mink Art says she wants the sphere shader so badly. My current one is more like spatula shader.
Sam, did you get a hold of Pat?
Well, she's been talking about it. She's still not sure if she's going to be able to get that. Optima. So she's currently trying to decide what she's going to do.
So right now I bumped up the heat to 4 so that I can get some darker areas in so it looks a little bit more realistic.
Dimensional stuff.
I'm trying. So... the whole thing is not going to be dark. And if I just did one tone, it'd be really flat looking. So I need to get in more darks. And since we have more darks on the hummingbird, I know this area can go darker too. And in doing this, hopefully, I can make it look like it's raised and popping out at you.
Okay.
But I can still go back and put the midtones in because that's just a quicker glide of the pen. So let's try. How's that coming out? It almost looks more like camouflage.
Well, moss does have it.
That's true. That is true. So let's try to see if I can stay in a smaller area. That one is darkened it out. See, I didn't adjust my heat. I'm just moving the pen more. And I'm slowing down for that higher heat. And lifting at the pen so that the tip recovers to hotter, the higher setting. The biggest thing that I can just keep over and over again pointing out is pen control. Even if you can't adjust your heat, moving it quicker means... I'm not speaking in sentences. I'm doing words, kind of. It's because I'm trying to focus.
Something about controlling your pain. Sorry, I zoned out a little there.
You're not supposed to zone out. You're at the helm.
I'm not at the helm. You're at the helm.
How am I at the helm?
You're the captain. I'm the first mate.
Okay, well.
Or perhaps a deckhand.
No, you're more than a deckhand. And even if you were, you're my deckhand. Oh. You're mine. Sometimes it's really hard to burn and talk. That's why I do the voiceovers on some videos because when I'm just burning to work, I've got my audiobook on, and other than glancing to make sure things are on screen, and sometimes they're not, for the camera, I'm just trying to burn. And I can get things done a little quicker if I'm not talking. But I gotta say, this treacle board, I really do like it.
Yeah, you've been pretty positive about it.
Yeah. Thus far, I haven't found anything negative, and I am looking. I think I will be buying more for myself. Unless I can sweet talk him into sending me some more.
So people would have to understand how exacting you are when you say that you're really looking. It's like, it's not a casual thing.
No.
Because Valarie really looks.
Yeah. Because if I'm going to tell you I recommend something, it better work. I get cranky.
It is true.
Yeah.
You didn't like her when she's cranky.
I still have a vortex of swirling cuss words above her head.
From what?
Anytime I get mad while I'm burning.
Oh.
It just kind of gets stuck up there in the ceiling fan.
Is that what those are?
That's what that is. Gotta be careful. One of these days it's gonna suck us in. Alright. I'm gonna turn this upright so that I can see how we're doing. I do need to darken down here. Here, this is going to be a lighter area. The moss does go up a little bit more and comes down. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my pencil just so it's easier for me and kind of outline a little darker so I know where things are.
Wow, we're only on a 10-second delay today.
Don't.
What?
Don't jinx us.
No, I'm just amazed.
Don't jinx us. Let's see here. So.
Pod's just thanking you for sharing advice, even though it was harder for you to do that while you're working.
It is. I'm trying. And sometimes my brain's like, overload. Let's see here. I know. This.
Pod says the moss looks awesome.
There you go.
It does look awesome.
Let's see here. It needs a little bit more work, but. So I got that in. But I do need to darken down here because we want it to look like the branch that it is. Sorry. There we go. Alright, so this is going to be darker. Like, overall darker. But we've also got the branch. So we can put actually a little bit of line. And I'm just using the edge. Again, there's going to be fog down here, but the fog actually goes behind the branch. So, I'm going to get some of these darks in. Because this area is throwing me off for the rest of the bottom. So, I'm going to get those in.
I wonder where the term throwing me off came from. If you think about it, it'd be like quite literal.
Is that
like,
good?
Did you guys manage to take that bridge in the battle? You know, now they threw us off. I got thrown off.
So is that our existential question of the day?
One of many.
Huh?
One of many.
One of many?
Yes.
Okay, but I think we need to keep it to just one.
Just a one? Why?
Well, my brain's already having a hard time. Let's see here. Some of the wood is exposed in some places, and I think I'm going to add a little bit more exposure. So that would be darker inside here. And because of the heat from the heel of the tip, and I'm on four still, the residual heat from the edge burned the wood partially, but that's okay. But in general, when you're doing lettering, or if you're doing more of a outlining for comic book style, you have to pay attention to that happening, because then you won't have as clean line. But I'm not trying to do that. And erase.
Oh, it's really dark.
Oh, right there? Yeah. And that's because this is going to go darker. I really don't want any of the moss, I think, standing out here. Right now I'm using more of the whole pin, the whole tip, instead of just the end of it.
Well, that's something that I didn't really appreciate until I tried it out. Is that how much nuance and variation there is between how you hold the pen, the angle, pressure, speed, and heat settings. Like,
they all work together.
Yeah, I know. It's a lot. It's a lot to keep track of.
But once you've been doing it for a little while, it does become easier.
Well, yeah, I'm sure. But I'm just saying, it's a lot.
So I'm blending that moss in a little bit more. The tree is going to have to, branch is going to have to go darker. But, and we don't see, like, if this branch really has any texture. It does have not only the moss, but it has some lichen on it. But we don't see, like what you would see for traditional bark, the lines. But I can kind of put them in. But those lines need to go with the direction of the branch. So let's darken up some more. See, this would be just too much detail if you put in every little thing. It would really take away from the piece, because this is what everybody would be focused on. So I really need to push it back. And when I say push it back, so that it's not so bright. It's got value, a darker value in the burning.
Zoe Hitchhikes is here.
Hi, Zoe.
Zoe Hitchhikes.
Oh, yes. That's right. You renamed her. I forgot.
You rename her. I just
used... You repronounced.
Just used some accent.
Let's see here. You know, some of the direction... Like, I had a line going this way. And it was too... what's the word? Samey is the only thing.
Samey.
Yeah.
Sure.
I need to get rid of some of that so that it's not... I can always go back and do negative burning to reshape some of this if I need to, but I don't know that I'm going to need to. I had a dark line here, so I'm just going to burn it in. Put some more in there. But I'm not outlining these. At least not trying to. We've got some lost and found edges. We have overlapping. So we shouldn't have any straight lines.
Ersisten Glücksbergslicht.
Hi, Ersis.
Is here. Ersis.
You can definitely see how it can throw you off where the area isn't burnt. Because now it looks really dark, but as soon as I put the rest of it in, it's just going to be there and not stand out from everything else.
Wow.
And that's part of the patience of burning, is getting through the ugly stage and not giving up, spending that time to darken everything the way you want it in layers. Layers are our friends. If you can hear a fan, I'm sorry. The studio does get warm under these lights. You gotta have airflow.
I don't have a fan.
Well, if you want to turn it and share.
No.
Well, excuse me. I had to turn off the ceiling fan because it interferes with the how well the tip heats up. It cools the tip off. It works just like if I was blowing on the tip before touching down. Yeah, let's get some shading in here. Kind of break that up a little bit. Now there's other areas of the moss that have like longer strands of it, more, a little more leafy. And I'll put those in some places, but I think it would be too much to put it all in. Let's see here. So I was saying this is a tree branch, part of the tree branch added. So what I can do, so that it's not just a straight line, is kind of fade it into the moss. So it's not just a line. In fact, let's get rid of some of that. Let's see here. Do I need to bring the camera down?
We will in a minute. You keep going.
Oh, alright. Why don't I just do it now? Do it now! There we go. This is filling in rather quickly. Let's see, all the moss here I've got going up and down, but some of it needs to curve. Looking at the reference photo, it's not all just up and down. So I'll have to reshape it a little bit.
Yeah.
But I can, so not gonna worry. So, let's see here, we're still under, as we move into here, which there's some branch that's exposed here. This is actually a light, you know what, I'm going to turn down the heat as soon as I touch down. So this, we have a lighter branch area, and the light will be hitting here, so I don't want to burn it as dark. So I'll just put that in so I know it's there. And let's go ahead and burn some of the lighter. Even where there's lighter area, we still have shadow. Remember, you can always darken up. See, this is darker under here. The light is going to hit here. So let's get that in there. This is really going to get highlighted. So I'm just going to drag. Because I need to be able to get rid of these pencil lines. So I'm just trying to mark it out. Tapping kind of breaks that up too. Because we have it being brighter, the tapping, the stippling, is actually a little easier to control. And it keeps us from outlining. So I can take that off. We still have and yes, I do bounce around a lot. If my eye notices something, it's just easier for me to get in and do it before I forget.
See, I like it when you're able to do that when you're working, like when you're able to just kind of move around within the composition and work on what needs to be worked on. It's nice.
Yeah, I also think it helps your brain from like turning off because you're working in the same place over and over again, and then your brain tends to shut down.
Yeah, you know what I think is interesting, or bear with me.
Okay.
So, a lot of artists, Bob Ross was not the first one to do it, but, you know, but we see how Bob created his work, and you know, not all of his work, but, you know, we saw his style and how he produced the painting. And I think that it's interesting because when you're an artist and you're looking to, you know, try and get better, you know, you seek out other artists who are...
Where you want to be.
Where you want to be. And that's not something that we had. You know, 20 years ago, we'd actually have to go to that artist and, you know, work with them or be able to watch them somehow, because, or, you know, maybe buy their video or something like that. But you wouldn't have an access to a lot of their techniques, you know, and insight. And that's something that in art history that we just don't have. We don't have, you know, how the old masters worked, or, you know, we just don't have that kind of visual record. But we do on YouTube, and for Pyrography, you know, have a full record of your work. So when you become hugely famous, all that information will be right there.
Yeah, I don't see that happening.
I do.
So right here we have more exposed branch. So I'm trying to incorporate it more because I do want it to break up the what essentially becomes a pattern. So I'm trying to break it up. And on top we've got some moss that right here is the wood, and it's getting hit by light. Now, as it curves, it's going to get darker, but for now, just putting it in like this as a placeholder allows me the room to adjust it. So
what you said about patterns, I think, is really important because the human brain is able to distinguish patterns, and we don't see that kind of exact repetition in nature. And if your brain catches that in any way, shape, or form, it's going to diminish the piece, and it'll be less
impactful,
naturalistic, and your people will be able to catch that on an unconscious level. They might not even know why.
Yeah.
They'd be like, oh,
don't care for it.
This looks like artificial somehow.
Yeah.
I don't know why. You know, and then you'd have, like, you know, your trolls who'd say, oh, this was Photoshopped, because you can see the repetition. But yeah, so if you want to replicate nature or emulate nature, then even though there's plenty of patterns in nature, there's not identical repeating patterns. I mean, I'm sure there is to an extent, but when it comes to art, you really don't want that. Pog, that's nice.
What's that?
He said that I'm the most awesomest person that he's ever seen.
When is he seeing you? Oh, wait a minute. No, your videos.
I lied. He said, I really appreciate YouTube and content providers like you, too.
Oh, thank you.
So.
Hey, Trey.
Eve's back.
Yay.
Shady's back. Back again.
Excuse me.
Shady's back.
Where are you getting that from?
No, it's a song.
Oh. Let's see here. Yeah, this is definitely going to take more work, but... See, this area, the moss hangs down, so I need to make sure and kind of put it in that way, because on the other ones I was going back and forth, left or right, but now... I need to pay attention to how it hangs down. You just kind of break it up a little bit. I'm on 3, so it's not burning as dark. That's by choice. Get some of this in there. Don't want it all going like straight up and down. Because then, again, we get that repetitive pattern. So we do need to break it up a little bit. And it will be darker. You see up here, it's a little more, they're shorter. So I can almost put them in like fish scales.
Mm.
Just kind of tapping. But tapping in the direction that they're going. Let's see here.
The signing's talking about patterns. She has a hard time with patterns. Because her brain loves patterns. And makes them up, even though there's none on the reference photo. that's an important point, because like our brains, like when you start doing something repetitious, your brain will like take that repetitious motion, whatever it is, and lock onto it and then automatically replicate it. So it's something that you have to fight against when you're doing any kind of pattern work or trying not to make pattern work in art. Interesting fact. Oh God, I'm that guy. Anyway,
you've always been that good.
Safety perspective, like stairs, like the human brain, when you're walking up or down stairs, by the time that you've taken your third step, your brain already has measured everything and will do the minimum amount of work. So like you'll notice like when you're walking upstairs, like your feet barely clear the steps because your brain's already measured it and adapted it. And you're just basically an autopilot. That's why, from a safety standpoint, that any stairs that are uneven are a hazard, because your brain won't be expecting that and you'll trip. So that is a compliance point. It's a safety point when we're looking at certifying stairs.
Yeah.
I don't do that anymore. But I think that just illustrates how exacting our brains can get and how well
the human brain deals with creating and replicating patterns.
And that's what I was kind of talking about on the on bouncing around, because the brain goes on autopilot. Mm-hmm. It actually goes into a meditative state, which is one of the reasons my words stop. Now I switched over to the smallest spoon shader that I'm still testing. I don't know if Pat's making them now. Probably should call and ask him. And because it is similar to a ball tip in how it burns without the roughness of what a ball tip can do, with the blobs, the dots, I can get a smoother burn, but it still heats up and moves across the board similar to a spoon shader. Or I'm sorry, to a ball tip, but it also takes less heat. Like right now I'm on 3 and it's burning pretty hot. So we're going down.
That's an interesting question.
Hmm.
So Chris says, I know Val sells her work. And he's asking, but do I do too? Yeah, I do.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we both do. So what's the question?
That may have been the question. But
oh.
I think one thing that always comes up when I think about this, like especially watching you do pyrography, is value. And you know, there's like for originals, the originals are expensive because there's so much time is put into them. And so we have like a computation per size that takes into account time.
Linear square inch.
Yeah, and so it's no different than like a mechanic, you know, working, you know, on your vehicle, you know, charges you X amount per hour to do that work, you know. But so that's the same for artists. But it's hard in this economy because a lot of people don't have a lot of extra money. So like I haven't sold an original piece except in the live auction.
It's been a while.
It's been a long time since I sold an original piece because
But in fairness, you also do 4-foot to 6-foot pieces as well.
That's true. You know.
And that I think makes a big difference. It's harder to ship and costs more.
Yeah.
And harder to frame.
I do need to do some smaller pieces. I just don't like once I started doing large work. I really enjoy it. So it's hard for me to go smaller now. But I do have some small canvases, so maybe
you
I should.
Do.
But I do think that, like, one of the things that we have to keep in mind is, you know, like, art for the people, you know? Cool. Like, how do you get the art to the people? That was one of the things that around the beginning of the 19th century, a lot of artists were kind of struggling with, because up to that point, art was for rich people only. And, you know, how do you get the art to people, you know, everywhere, but also be able to make a living.
Yeah. So, no, I recognize that my art isn't cheap.
I mean, that's why we do prints, but we haven't really fully committed to that. We don't have all the...
I gotta find time to do all the photos.
Yeah, I know. And I'm gonna help with that. But I'm not falling asleep.
Yeah, you gotta kind of stay awake for that. This is definitely going quicker with the small spoon shader. And I actually bumped down the heat to 2.5 because it was going hotter than that. Or it was burning hotter than I wanted. Nothing wrong with the pen, it's just each tip burns differently. And if I had the ball tip set at the same temperature, it wouldn't be burning as dark. But I can use it for multiple textures. And when you're looking at buying pens, that's one thing you really should look for is how many different ways will this pen Can I use this pen to burn different things?
Yeah, that's true.
If the pen only works for one style or texture, you really need to think about, should you buy that pen? Because you don't need a ton. But I will say that the spoon shader burns differently than the spear shader. And that's what I'm going for.
I'm sorry to come off topic with the burning.
Oh, that's fine, because my brain, for whatever reason today, my brain just, like, keeps...
But it's evident in your work, because you're kicking ass. It's because you, so your mouth doesn't work, but your hand is going overtime. Love you.
Love you.
So, Cheryl, yeah, so that's an interesting point, because Cheryl says that she doesn't know about feeling, how she feels selling hers. She says she did a little piece once as a gift and didn't want to part with it. And I think that that's very important. Like, I know artists that they just, like, put out a massive amount of work and they're okay with parting with it, but they haven't become emotionally engaged with their work, and it, I think a lot of times it shows. And I used to manage a gallery in Alaska, and we had a few artists that submitted pieces, and you could tell the ones that they were engaged with and the ones that they weren't. And, you know, it's like when a piece comes in, when somebody creates a piece, whether it's you or somebody else, and you really, really care about that piece, you impart something to it that's beyond just the paint, or
it's part of you.
Yeah, it's something that's infused into the work, and people can tell the difference. You can put a bunch of pieces together, and the one that people will stop and look at will be the one that the person has put their heart into. And when you have a piece like that, of course you don't want to part with it, because I always say it's like parting with your children. You know, it's like something you just don't want to do because you spent so much time with it, and you know, you love it, and you don't want to part with it. So, you know, that's why, like, for me, I don't have any problem with this because I haven't sold anything in a while. But, you know, with me, it's like, okay, what is it worth to me parting with? And I think that that's the value of your work.
See, but I don't know. I have a little different view on that. You know. And there's nothing wrong with that. It's just, there's plenty of pieces that I've done that, yeah, I really like them. But I did them because I would like to see them go to a good home.
Yeah.
And so, I don't... If there's a piece that I really, really, really think I want to have and keep, I'll just make a print of it. And I can keep the print.
That's true.
I'm not so attached.
Oh, that I you're can't. So giving, Valarie.
No, it has nothing to do with that. You know, if you don't want to sell your work, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
I'm teasing you.
I know, but I'm doing more than just creating this for me. You know.
Yeah. Well, that's true. That was something that was in a YouTuber that I follow.
Just being honest about it, I'm burning what I want to burn. But in the back of my mind, I know that if it calls to somebody else, that's where it needs to go.
Yeah.
I'm burning what I want to burn, but I don't have any... issue selling it to somebody else that it may call to.
Yeah. I don't necessarily mind that either. It has to be for the right price. Although I would say that depending on how much somebody loves your work, that has an impact on how you price it too. You know, like, I would rather sell my work to somebody who really, really, really wanted it and I knew that loved it. I'd rather sell them that piece and have them, you know, pay less for it.
Mm-mm.
Rather than... No, let me finish my thought.
Okay, because...
Rather than it go to somebody who doesn't care about the work. And it's just going to sit.
See, again, I disagree. One, I'm well, not going to...
We're just full of disagreement.
But it's okay. We don't have to agree on everything. But I'm not going to lower the price for somebody who really wants it. Because in lowering the price on that, I've just devalued that in my other work. By lowering the price, I've devalued it.
If I lowered the price, no one would know.
It would be
a pact that person and I took to the grave.
Well, that is personal between you and that person, yes. But if you're showing that piece and somebody goes, hey, I'll give you $5,000 for that piece, and somebody walks up next to him and says, oh, I just love it so much, and you can see the love in their eyes, and you can feel it coming off of them, but they can only pay $2,700. Who's going to get it? The person willing to pay the asking price, or the person who seems to be reacting to it more emotionally?
I don't like this game.
I mean, that's all personal to each artist. I don't think there's a wrong answer to that question. I really don't. But in selling it for less than what you've priced it at because somebody loves it, you've really devalued it.
Ursis has to go.
Hi, Ursis.
And Paolo is here.
Hi, Paolo.
Kathy Whitney's here.
Hi, Kathy. It's okay if we don't agree, love.
I know.
Again, I think it's personal to each artist. There's no right or wrong answer to the question. It's what feels right to you. In the end, it's still your art.
I think that the hope for every artist is that your art goes to people who appreciate it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. At the same time, and I don't want people to think that I'm coming off as all about the money, but let's face it, you need the money to eat and have a roof over your head and buy some more supplies so you can create more art. You know? Now, if we were famous artists who was comfortable... I think doing pieces for charity work and other things is very, very important. I mean, even though you do charity work with your pieces.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, those are the only ones that have moved.
But you've also been painting things for you.
Well, that was another point that I was going to make, is that, because that was a video that Caesar had.
Yeah.
That when people say that they do art for themselves, that's not really correct. You're not just doing art for yourself that no one will ever see. Of course you're doing art for other people as well, because you're creating something beautiful to put out in the world. Now, there might be some people who do beautiful art that nobody ever sees. And those people are truly doing art for themselves. But the majority of artists are doing art for the world in some way, shape, or form. So when you do art, you know, yeah, you want to do something that you love and you have investment in it, but you do have to keep in mind that you are putting it out in the world. So, and there has to be some connection there.
Yeah.
Although, there's artists that put their stuff out there without regard for other people, and even a little antagonistic, you know, like...
What do you mean?
Well, people that put out art that's hostile, that's not for beauty's sake, it's like a statement.
Yeah, but is all art meant to be for beauty's sake?
No, but it is visual communication.
It is.
But so for those artists that say, you know, oh, I don't care what people think, I'm putting this out there to, you know, and I hope it offends them.
Then you do care what they think.
Exactly. And that's my point. So you are putting art out into the world, not just for yourself.
All right. So I'm trying to get the flow of the moss hanging down. So that's why I've flipped the board. I'm going in one direction. And that's just so I can get that flow. And of course, we do still have the contrast, and it needs to be, you know, I kind of lost the moss here. What I could do, because I really don't want to scratch it out, is I can do this more horizontal and just make it all exposed bark. I think that would work better if I do this as exposed bark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Versus scratching it out. I really don't like scratching out. And if some people don't mind doing it, I just don't like it. I'll do it if I have to, but if I can get around it, then I'll go for that.
Cheryl makes an interesting point here.
What's that?
She worries that when people when she's making art, that people aren't necessarily honest with her. She's worried that they're just being nice to her.
I feel that all the time.
And she says, so she has her hubby give them the art, and that way, like, I guess there's more of a chance that they'll be honest.
Has it worked? Because I would think if they knew it was your husband, that they would still be nice about it, because now you got two factors, not only the artist's feelings, but the husband's, or the significant other's feelings. And the significant other's looking you in the eye. But let me know if that works, because I'll try that.
Well, I could have a disguise. I could have a beard, mustache, and some, like, 70s glasses. And I could be your agent. Or I could just be the delivery guy. And it'd be like, yeah, here's the art, you know? Oh, it's pretty radical. What do you think? And then, you know, they'd say what they really think. And if they're mean, I'd rip my disguise off. And I'd be like, aha! I'm telling Valarie. But I'll take your money anyway.
Yeah. I think it's a really good idea, Cheryl. I'm just curious how people react to your husband. Because there's always that personal wanting to protect.
Chris has been doing pricing her by the hour. Oh, we must have buffered.
Did we?
Yeah. It skipped.
Aww.
She says yes. She's very honest with her, and it does work.
So oh, okay. That's good. Cool. Maybe we should try that.
All right. Well, thanks, Cheryl. I have another job. No.
Well, you're already supposed to be my manager, and I'm supposed to be yours.
That's true. Oh, that makes sense now. You rolled your eyes.
So hard. I had to actually move
your head.
I so had to move the pin off the board so that I did not tap down as I was doing the full roll.
Okay. See, and Chris has been pricing hers by the hour. Keep track of time so that that she still feels it's undervalued. And that, you know what? That undervalued thing, that hurts. Like, it's so hard.
Is hard.
Because right now we're hanging in a gallery with other artists. Well, not a gallery, but...
We're hanging in two
different places. And the one place is just our art, just me and Val's art. The other place, we share the space with... It's a fancy restaurant, and we share the space with a couple other artists. Mm-hmm. And there's a couple other artists in there, and not all the work is the same. Some of it's handmade lithographs, there's some ceramics in there, but there's also
different medias and styles.
Yeah, but there's also paint, you know, actual painters. No, actual painters, that sounds fancy, too fancy. I didn't mean it like that. So there's people who also do painting in there, and like there's some that sell their work all the time in there,
But, like, the price difference in between my work and their work.
Yep.
It's like, okay, so, like, if I've got a piece, you know, like my Jupiter, it's 4 foot by 4 foot. And so that's, you know, a significant price tag, you know, if I've got, but, you know, but if I've got another piece that's like, you know, oh, God, like, I'm trying to think what else is down there, but so I've got some smaller pieces down there, like, oh, no, the wolves aren't down there anymore. Well, they were. They were down there.
Just a smaller piece.
Yeah, but a smaller piece. So if that smaller piece is like 1,200, and it's competing with another piece that...
It's 150.
That's 150, you know, that's hard, because that 150 piece, that $150 piece is going to move, you know.
It's more likely to.
It's more, yeah, it's more likely to, you know, and that's... That's good for that artist. They're selling the work, but on the other hand, you know, what does that do to, you know? And I'm not blaming that artist or anything like that. But although I do feel like that artist is maybe undervaluing their work, you know, but they're putting themselves in a place where down the line it's going to be harder for them to raise their prices if they need to, you know. So, you know. And this is something that my dad ran into when he was doing woodworking, is that, you know, he makes beautiful, beautiful work, but people don't want to pay what it's worth because, you know, they got some of his work in trades, or some of his work, you know, got for not nearly as much as it was worth. But now they use that as a bargaining point, you know, like, oh, well, you want, you know, $800 for this. Well, the last time I got something like this from you, it was like 150, you know, and why should I pay 800 when I paid 150 for, you know, that? And so it devalues your time, you know. Then again, there's the, you know, gotta make rent, you know. Mm-hmm. If you're $150 short, do you sell that piece for $150 and bite the bullet? Life's hard.
It is. And see, I don't do hourly. I don't do an hourly, computation, because I just take longer to work and I don't feel right for me. Now this is for me. Charging, you know, whatever I did hourly and then turning around and saying, but the piece took me 100 hours to do. It just, it's really hard thing to figure out. Mm-hmm. You do have to find, and but again, you're also balancing that with what are people willing to pay.
So for me, the answer is, and we, because Val and I have agreed on like the per square inch pricing, and we price both of our works the same way. But for me, the answer is prints, because
yeah,
it's a different market, especially in our work, because the price difference is so vast. So the person who's looking at buying an original from me or buying a print is not the same person.
Yeah, it's two different
people. It's two different people and two different demographics. And that's fine, you know. And that's, you know, and that's how I'm moving forward. But, no, I don't have a YouTube channel. Val's pushing me towards it.
I'm trying.
I've agreed to do it. I just haven't done it because I've been teaching my 17-year-old how to drive.
Yes, that's true.
Which could be a whole different YouTube channel.
That it could be.
But no, it's a, she's a good driver, so it would be kind of dull.
She needs to smooth out her nuance.
Although the other day she was cussing at somebody behind her in traffic. That was
okay.
That,
that's from me. I'm sorry.
That was riding a bumper.
I'm sorry.
And I can't.
That's me.
And I can't help but still picture her at three with pigtails and her big glasses, sitting there, like, not even looking, being able to look over the steering wheel, but saying, like, really foul things to the person behind them in traffic. So, but yeah. So,
I'm sorry. That's my doing.
But I think that
she listens to me.
Once she's, you know, because she's got to go back to Alaska here.
The end of the month.
At the end of the month. So I think then I'll be
doing the YouTube channel then.
That's right, because you're not going back to school because you graduated.
Because now I got to work in the real world.
Yeah, you do.
And whoops.
Yeah, you do.
I work in acrylics, follow.
In oil.
In oil.
Somewhat.
And graphite and charcoal, but some watercolor. But the stuff that I put up for sale is acrylics and oils.
Yeah, so this is looking more like it's hanging down, but I do need to get more, I need more shadow to pop out the lighter areas.
It picks by Liz says, finding someone who appreciates the art and is willing to buy it no matter what cost is difficult.
Oh, yeah.
She says she wouldn't believe the people at shows that want to haggle for the price of a 25-cent bookmark.
That's very true.
Man, we had a show at a coffee shop a while back, and we had bookmarks for sale.
$2.
$2.
$2 big bookmarks. Ones, too. In fact, one of them's right there, though, if you want to grab it.
Okay.
It's an old. This is like 4 years ago.
But how many did we lose that people just walked off with?
Well, they brought them back.
Oh, it was staff?
It was staff.
Yeah.
Yeah, one of Jason's old bookmarks. So $2, but they were laminated. So this is just the base. They were laminated, and they had tassels on them. This is all old information.
I can't see the whole piece.
Well, I'm all zoomed in. Sorry.
So this original is like 2 by 3 feet.
It's bigger than that.
Is it?
Yeah. It's a 3 by 4. It's 3 by 4.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a 36 by 48.
You're right.
Yeah. I know, because I have to label everything. But that one hasn't shown in a while. But yeah, $2. Like I said, they were laminated and all. Why is there blue on my board?
Why is it what?
You're shitting me.
What happened?
The ink from
The ink from the book?
Yep.
Really? And that's why we laminated them.
There shouldn't be.
God, I really like this. I forgot how cool.
Luckily, it's coming up. I would have been not happy.
Not happy.
Not happy. It looks like.
Is that a way for you to say you're angry without having to say you're angry?
Well, I think the cuss word gave it away.
Oh. Oh my.
I think I got. Yeah, I don't know why it did that. It shouldn't have. It's odd.
I don't know.
Something else is on it.
Maybe.
Considering it's just hanging on my whiteboard, I don't know why. But yeah, it turned out to be the staff, and we asked that, you know, these have a price on them, please make sure people buy them. And the next time we came in, they were all back. Because they took like 95% of them.
Yeah.
And there was a good 30 bookmarks.
Yeah. You're excited. Like, oh, wow.
I know. Bookmarks. We sold them.
You know, hey, it's something.
And so when we asked, hey, where's the money for the bookmarks? There's only $2 for it. It's like, where'd they all go?
Picks by Liz says, yes, running off with bookmarks seemed to be a game at some of her shows. She had to put them in an album and then get, you know.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, that is a good idea. But we stopped doing that, though. We stopped, like, putting stuff. Like, what we have now is we have a link on our tags, our identification tags for our work that hangs. And so then if people want to buy our stuff, they can follow those links.
Yeah.
But we did have, at one point, we had prints made up and the bookmarks and stuff, and we left those with, you know, the people at the show. But that's always hard, having somebody else curate your stuff and keep track of your stuff. And then we really learned, because the bookmark thing was
frustrating.
Yeah,
because we got all excited.
You know what this looks like?
What's it look like?
It looks like the Grinch's arm.
A little bit. It does look like that a little bit. And with that, we are at 12:30 and my eyes need a break.
Oh, is it time?
It is time. Let's zoom out.
Okay.
And pop off the
So here, right?
Up, yep.
This?
Either one. It's fine.
Okay.
Go to home?
Home.
Alright, go to the other one. It's not popping it up.
Okay.
Up. There you go. See, zoom, slide it down.
Like that?
Yep.
Okay.
There we go. And then pop off, please, the black and white photo I've got up.
Okay.
Hold on. Other screen. He's learning.
I am the intern.
Down at the bottom.
Black and white.
You'll see.
Some moss black and white.
Yep. Click that up. There you go.
Okay.
In fact, I could probably make them a little dizzy. Let's back it out.
Oh, all right, that's excited. No, not excited. Mockiness.
Mock, mock, mock. There we go. We'll do that. Wow, I got actually quite a bit in, a lot more in than I expected to. I mean, it still needs work. I still need to blend things out, but I at least have it laid down and looking at it. Let's see here. Let's cut off the lights. There we go. So this is darker, so I need to pay attention. These areas that are dark are going to have to get closer to this value tone. Nice. See, it looks so far away, but it's really not. It's right there. Mm-hmm. The camera's still too close.
It's all the way zoomed out.
I know. I'm talking about me. Yeah.
Okay.
Like that. Kind of like that. Hopefully we can see it a little better. Oops, sorry. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Do this. Bring it in.
Yeah, pods. That's one thing that we learned. It's like, especially if you're going to put your work in a place where people are coming for something else, because people will always choose the other thing. So if your art's in the coffee shop, they're going to buy coffee and look at the art. They're probably not going to buy your art.
Yeah.
You know, and that's just the way life is. But it is sad that people don't see the value in something that was created by hand.
Oops. I'm just knocking everything around. I'm trying to get a good lighting so that it's a little more true to the burning.
But maybe if they subscribe to your channel, then they'll understand the value and how much time it takes. Eh?
I know. So, next week, you know what? I think next week I want to be a little more lazy, especially since it's going to be the day before my birthday.
Now you're talking.
And I'm going, I'm not always, lazy, just
I'm always down a little for
more,
lazy.
A little more relaxed. Little more relaxed, and I think we're gonna do mushrooms.
We're gonna do mushrooms live. Well, you heard it here.
We are going to do the mushrooms live. I still can't get my lighting where I want it.
That will be an interesting stream.
Yes, we're doing the mushrooms. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's 9 mushrooms visually on this side of the board, but I think we are going to focus on these 3 here and maybe the one in the back. I don't remember what kind of mushroom that is in the back. That way we have a couple of different textures going on. Like I said, the moss isn't done yet. Can you pull that string up there for the light? Because I'm just not getting the light that I want. I don't know what's going on. Why?
Let's see. Paula says that'll go viral.
Yeah. There we go. Maybe that's a little better.
Well, Chyla's saying some really nice things, so you need to read all that.
Oh, I will read it all. Thank you so much.
Oh no, Paula Lott is here at the end.
Daughter, huh?
Paula Lott.
Hi, Paula.
But we have
I don't see her up on the screen.
Oh,
that's why it was throwing me off. Oh, there's Paula. Hey, Paula. Alrighty, if we don't have any more questions. Oh, and again, World Watercolor Month. Well, that's July. That's now. But World Pyrography Month starts August 1st. It's for everyone who wants to participate, and up in the eye card, there's an eye that's right in this area right there. If you click on that, it'll take you over to the announcement video for World Pyrography Month. I also have a poll in that video, so if you'll hit the iCard in that video, you can say whether or not you're going to be participating. So, if you're new here, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. We are over 3,100 now.
That's awesome.
We are at, before the live, it was 3,116. Ooh. I know. We're growing, and I want to thank all our new subscribers.
That's awesome.
They are awesome. They're all awesome. I love our toasties. Yep. They're fabulous. So, make sure to leave a comment and click like, and we will see you next week. Happy 4th of July and happy burning.
Taking a nap.
Bye.